Today is May 22nd, 2020, and we're still in the middle of a global pandemic. I'm Paul Shapiro, and like most of us, I've been under quarantine lockdown in my home for the better part of the last 10 weeks. Yes, it has been surreal, and it's also been deadly. 100,000 deaths in the U.S. so far, more casualties than the Vietnam and the Korean War combined, and we don't have a vaccine anywhere in sight. There is some good news, though. Infections are slowing down, and lockdown restrictions are beginning to loosen. This weekend, we are entering into phase one of reopening here in Connecticut. Among those allowed to open this weekend are restaurants for outdoor facilities only. You probably already know that the restaurant industry has been decimated by the pandemic, especially independent restaurants. According to the Beard Foundation and the Independent Restaurant Coalition, it's predicted that months of closed doors, mounting debt, and diminished capacity could permanently close as many as 80% of America's independent restaurants. Let that sink in. That means that 4 out of 5 of your favorite restaurants could close permanently. Right now, millions of U.S. restaurant workers are unemployed and face permanent job loss, and most restaurant owners are struggling with questions about their future, whether to reopen or not. The much-hyped Paycheck Protection Program has reached just a fraction of the restaurants that need it most, and those who did receive funds are supposed to use them to cover 8 weeks of payroll while closed. Sorry, that's illogical, and it would be laughable if it weren't so tragic. Meanwhile, they keep accumulating mountains of losses and debt. I grabbed my camera and visited one of my favorite local restaurants tonight, just a couple miles from my home, Milwrights in Simsbury, Connecticut, because the state just activated phase one that allows restaurants to serve food outside. So I was curious how a restaurant without any outside service would be able to pull that off. This is Tyler Anderson. He's the chef owner of Milwrights. Maybe you recognize him from Chopped, Beat Bobby Flay, or Top Chef. Tyler has been honored with Connecticut Chef of the Year and has been nominated Best Chef in the Northeast U.S. according to James Beard. He's done that for 6 years in a row. I wanted to see how Tyler was going to safely reopen to the public. So this is Milwrights outside. The first thing that you're going to notice is that it's absolutely gorgeous. Tables are at least 6 feet away from each other, and safety is clearly on everyone's mind. From the kitchens where food is prepared to the tables where it's served, safety is clearly what matters most. The masks, gloves, the constant sanitizing, the changing of linens, and PPE is worn even in harsh conditions. Safety is taken very seriously here.
I have to say we have really thought every angle through. The number one priority is the safety, not only of our team, but our guests. We would not be opening our doors if we felt it was not a safe environment for everyone. Extreme thorough sanitation standards. We have a whole guide that's on our website for what you would expect out of a sequence of service. So when you come in and join us, it has everything mapped out from your entry to your departure. Minimal contact with our guests, and we try to make everything as contactless as possible to ensure the safety of our entire team and all of our guests that are in here to join us.
It comes down to this. This team is organized and they're united. And even the water station practices social distancing. But really, it's awful nice to see people back outside, enjoying themselves in this gorgeous environment and eating some really great food. There was a dream that one day I could see it. Like a bird in a cage, I broke in and demanded that somebody breathe.